Hi, I'm Chief Green, Woodstock Fire and EMS.
And I'm Chief Robbie Blish with the Woodstock Police Department. Today we want to talk to you about some of the additions and alterations to the Woodstock Emergency Services Building. Behind us are the plans to these new buildings. And in just a little bit, we'll take a tour of the entire building so that we can give you a better picture of what we're talking about.
So just to give you a little history of this building originally started life in the 1940s as a Chevy dealership and a gas station. Woodstock Fire moved in here sometime in the 70s from a downtown location after a minor remodel.
At some time in the early or late 80s to early 90s, the police department addition was put onto the building and the communications center was also moved into their existing location.
While we've been here a long time and this building has worked well for us, our needs and our call volume is growing in this town. And we need to be able to do our job to protect you with a new space. So over here, everything in white is the existing building. The two new gray sections are additions. One of the reasons we're adding additions is we need sleeping quarters in this town. We've run out of office space and we've run out of storage space. So by adding this addition and remodeling the building, we gain everything we need for many years to come. Sleeping quarters will be on the second floor along with certain offices. And then on the first floor, below that, is the apparatus bays, because during the remodel, we lose two bays in the existing part of the building.
So these plans provide a clear picture of what's going to happen to the remodeling. The existing building is pretty much all of this section here. And this is where the dispatch center is. That's not going to move. The lobby won't move. But our police department side will receive some of the renovations. What's important to know is that the existing building would not support a second level. And that's why it's important that we put on a rear addition, which is going to be here. And then this is where the upper level Chief Green just referred to will be, and what will house office space and some bunk rooms for EMS personnel primarily, but also anyone else that may need that space in an emergency situation.
Yep, so below it are the new apparatus bays, because we lose two existing bays right here. This bay will not be touched at all. It'll just be spruced up and hopefully an exhaust capture system and medical supplies will be stored outward. There is one thing, important thing to note about all of this. Is we did look at moving this project and building to other locations. However, the best piece of property we found that suits our needs within the town came in at roughly a $1.3 million price tag. And we felt, being sensitive to taxpayers' needs, that we should stay here. We can do everything we need with this property, a remodel and an addition. Originally, we looked at a complete tear down of this building, which proved very costly. The estimates were coming in at $6 million. We had extreme difficulties housing police, fire, and dispatch in other locations. And dispatch takes the 911 calls and sends them out to either fire, police, or other towns. And that system cannot be out for more than an hour. And this, by moving them, would put them out for a day, if not 2 days.
So again, part of the renovation is going to enable the police department to have a secure sally port. The Woodstock Fire Department's antique fire truck will be on display, but it'll be moved from an operational area where the trucks are to a more of a display area, which will provide additional space inside the bays for the fire department.
So on the second floor of the new addition, houses primarily fire and EMS. We also have sleeping quarters. One of the reasons for that is currently we house people from out of town that wish to do some ride time here in Woodstock in an apartment building, which is both a cost and a liability to the town. So by adding these, and also someday in the future, Woodstock EMS will be full-time and we would want these people on site.
When you look at the front of the building, what's proposed is a glassed-in front. This would be where the antique fire truck would be housed, but it also would provide an attractive frontage. As you come into the village or into the town itself, you'll see a building that's going to fit with the character of the existing community, but it'll also be useful. This will be the west end of the building. This is the Ace Hardware side of the building. And this is the back of the building.
Also proposed on the front of the building and under consideration is dedicating this building to Woodstock's 35-year town manager, Phil Swanson.
We're asking for your support for this worthwhile project. It's a project that we believe will benefit the Woodstock community as a whole and for many years to come. So we're starting our tour here on the police department side of the building. The room that we're in currently is what we refer to as our briefing room, but it also doubles as our DUI processing room. And also we have our mailboxes here as well. This room has a cable on the floor that we use to secure the prisoners. We don't have a dedicated holding cell, so in order to keep a prisoner secure, keep them from running out the door, or for officer safety purposes, attacking an officer, we have to handcuff them to a cable that's on the floor. This room also used to be part of an interview room, and we would have to put a sign up on each exit in order to let folks know that they can't come in, there's an interview in progress. We've since moved that to this room back here, but this room is now the interview room. However, the problem is it currently also does triple duty. So it is the interview room, but it also is the officer's locker room, and it also has a storage room. And then off of this room is the evidence room. So that evidence room, which I think you'll see a couple of pictures of it in just a little bit, the evidence room has triple duty. Currently it houses evidence, property, storage for files, storage for office stationery, and it also houses the secure server that we use for the state computer system that we have. So that, in addition to that, we've had several floods in that room because of faulty air conditioning systems that have been upgraded and replaced at different various times. Okay. So the next room I want to show you is our fingerprint and mugshot room. This room also doubles as a storage room because of our lack of space. This room, we have our inkless fingerprint system. It doesn't speak to the state. The state system is what's called MorphoTrack. It's about an $18,000 piece of equipment with a $3,000 a year maintenance fees. But if that system fails, we also have the ink system. And so I just want to show you this a little bit as I come in here. Next, I want to show you the officer's office. The officer's office is used by all of the patrol officers. They all share the same desk and the same computer. They also have some file drawers in there where they keep some of their personal effects. We also have some other file cabinets in there where we store stationery and some other evidence supplies. As I pointed out earlier, this is the officer's office. There's four patrol officers that are full-time that use this, and then another five or six part-time officers that also have to use this same office, the same workstation. The full-time officers have their file drawers that they can use to put some of their personal items in there. And then we have to have all of our batteries and radio storage here as well. Over here again is the officer's desk and their workstation. So as I pointed out earlier, four of the full-time officers currently have to use this same desk, as well as the other five part-time officers at any given time have to use the same workstation. Okay, so this room is my office that I share with Sergeant Swanson. Sergeant Swanson's office used to be what the dedicated interview room is now. I moved him in here so that we could make that a dedicated interview room and also allow the officers to have some locker space. But we share the same office. It also doubles as some property storage and also equipment storage. And anytime that we have a private meeting, one or the other one has to leave the room. So it really is tight quarters for us. One thing I'd like to point out is this is the rear entrance where the officers come in, but we have to use this entrance space as storage for our ammunitions. We have a bank of lockers here that we put our ammunition in, and then up top we have to store all our weapons cleaning supplies. This last office is the office that belongs to the administrative secretary. She also handles our parking tickets, so there's a window that allows public access to her. It also contains file storage cabinets as well as some limited storage available for office supplies.
Good.
Well, right now we're standing in the lobby of the Emergency Services Building. This lobby will pretty much remain unchanged. However, we will have a secure door here after the remodel because as of now, there is free access to the emergency services personnel who are in their office. It does become a security problem having free access to the emergency services personnel as of today. And then once we have the remodel and we have the secure door here, we'll have a holding cell and a sally port, which we currently do not have. A sally port is where we can pull the police vehicle into a secured garage and then take the prisoner out of that vehicle. So this room is the emergency services personnel office that I mentioned that's off of the lobby area. Currently, all of the EMTs have to use the same desk and workstation along with the Woodstock Ambulance Coordinator, Misha McNabb. This room also doubles as storage space for the ambulance folks. And when it's remodeled, this will become the police department's DUI processing room, as well as prisoner processing room, fingerprint, and mugshot room. So right now, we're standing in the communications center. This is sort of the heart and soul of emergency services. These are the folks you talk to when you call for help. These are the people who are gonna be able to send that help to you. Right now, we dispatch for Woodstock Police, Woodstock Fire, South Woodstock Fire, Woodstock Ambulance, Pomfret, Tego Fire, Fast Squad, Bridgewater Fire and Fast Squad, and also the Woodstock Highway Department. This room will not see much of an expansion under the new remodel. However, they will receive a kitchenette so that they can prepare a meal, because currently they're not allowed to leave the dispatch center to prepare a meal. They have to bring their meals here prepared. Another problem that we have in this room is that because of all the computer equipment, it needs to be air conditioned year round. There's only one zone in this building, so during the winter months, the air conditioning is competing with the heating system throughout the rest of the building. Furthermore, the ductwork system is uncleanable and unserviceable at this time. So right now we are standing in what is currently the fire department side of the building, but under the remodeling, this will become a dedicated locker room and then a interview room. Also, I want to point out that right now, if you look at the ceiling, there's duct tape covering the AC vents, which I mentioned a little bit earlier in the communications room. It has to be on for all the communications equipment, but the rest of the building also needs to be heated. So we cover the vents with duct tape so that it doesn't compete as much.
Okay, so here we are in our training room, which is currently used for fire department training, EMS training. The police also use it for training, and sometimes the public uses it for training. While this space stays largely unchanged, a conference room will be added to the back of the room, a wall will be moved over here, and everything will be shuffled over just a whisker. Vermont Efficiency has done an audit of this building, and they have pointed out several needs. However, looking into these needs, we have found it too expensive in the building state to do any of this. One of our biggest needs is the building roof system is a mishmash of cold and hot roofs. So what that means is certain sections of the roof will melt, other sections will not. The sections that don't melt often give us problems. While we have a good roof membrane, the ice and snow will build up, causing major ice jams, which will then leak into our walls and cause damage, and we actually have to place buckets during the winter to catch the water. So all this would be fixed during this remodel. Another thing going along with that, on this end of the wall during the winter, we have a large expansion crack that opens up to roughly an inch and a half where you can look directly outside of the building. While we try to keep it filled, it's impossible, and we're just wasting heat right out of this building. On this wall behind me, we have a large crack that will appear during the winter. While we try to caulk it and stuff it with insulation, it's constantly moving. And we believe with the remodel, insulation will cure this problem. Currently, we're standing in the furthermost eastern end of the apparatus bay, which houses the ambulances and the police cars. So this section will be used by ambulances and fire trucks, as the police cars will be removed to another area. We also house all of our medical equipment in here, which is prone to getting wet, dusty, and contaminated with diesel fumes. All right, so in this section of the bay, and also in the previous bay we were in, OSHA's been in the building and made some recommendations. One of those recommendations is that these fire trucks and ambulances will be started and there's no exhaust capture system. Currently, the way everything is designed, it cannot be put into this building. So with the remodel, this space will be modified to make it fit an exhaust capture system. So what this will do is reduce the toxins that flow throughout of the building during the day, affecting office workers, police, and dispatch. Also in the remodel, we get a dedicated decontamination room. Currently, we only have a small shower, which offers no privacy right here in the bays. And if you need to be decontaminated, you're done it exposed to everybody watching you. So currently, the way the building is designed, it does not have a sprinkler or fire alarm system. In the project, this space, along with the rest of the building, will be protected by a sprinkler system and a fire alarm system. So currently, if there's any fire out here in these apparatus bays, roughly $3 million worth of taxpayer equipment is left unprotected. So also in the plan for the remodel, the antique, our 1923 antique fire truck, which was one of Woodstock's first motorized vehicles, which has remained with us, will be moved to a special space, allowing it to be shown off and preserving Woodstock's history. These two bays right here become workspace for medical supplies, for SCBA repairs and such. And also over here will be a dedicated gear storage space. So currently we're standing in front of my office, which at this point doubles as EMS building and obviously my office. In the future, everything in this office has to be secured under HIPAA rules, and we're running out of space. And the remodel will afford separate spaces for both of these functions, fire and EMS billing. As I talked about earlier, here we store our firefighter protective gear, which at certain scenes can be contaminated with carcinogens and other substances. Also, we regularly have to clean these. Right now, we only have a residential washer, which is not recommended for this gear. We have no dryer. It takes roughly 3 days to wash and dry a set of this gear. And in the remodel, we'd have the appropriate equipment and space for storage and cleaning of all this gear.
Well, we hope we answered a lot of your questions today, but in the future, we will be having a couple more open house tours, maybe in the evening, on the weekend. But if you're unable to make any of the announced tours when the dates do come available, feel free to give either myself or Chief Green a phone call, an email, smoke signal, and you can set up your own tour, and we'd be happy to show you around.
And also, if you have any questions and just want some more information, just feel free to give us a call or an email.